Next presentation is online. It's by Philip Ludewig.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. So you can start.
Perfect. Today I'll be presenting our work on 6 degree of freedom pose estimation to feed a pose of an existing rigid body landmark, in our case, a lunar lander, into a SLAM system to improve localization. First of all, I'd like to thank all of the people that helped make this research possible, as well as the Luxembourg National Research Fund that supported this work. So this work was initially done for the NASA Space Robotics Challenge, where we competed with the team Moon Raiders. This was a fully virtual competition where we had to operate multiple robots in a fully autonomous mode. And the simulation environment was provided to us as a gazebo simulation. So the problems we tried to solve was to have multiple robots operate in the same environment and to be able to localize towards the same reference point, which in our case was the lander. Initially, we would do this with artificial fiducial markers, but they're quite limited in size, and we also weren't allowed to change the lander. So we turned towards the novel pose estimation techniques, such as efficient pose, that can be used to also produce a 6 degree of freedom pose estimation. And essentially, we used the lander because it was the largest known structure, and because we already had a 3D model of how it was built. And this would also be applicable to a number of existing planetary exploration missions. And lastly, we didn't just want to have a single pose estimation, but we wanted to continuously integrate this pose estimation into our GraphSLAM system, where we used the RTAP map. So how did we proceed with this? Initially, we worked with an object detection system, YOLO in our case. This is mostly for efficiency purposes, because while efficient pose wasn't slow, it was still much faster to use a simple object detection to make sure that the object is in front of us. And only at that point, we would perform the rigid body pose estimation. Then we filter false detections. And then with the remaining detections, we estimate the confidence of the detections. And then we feed these into our GraphSLAM system with a covariance matrix that's based on the confidence value that we calculate. In order to train our efficient pose network, we created our own data set. With different images of different distances and orientations to the lander, and also different illumination conditions to make sure that our model will be robust to changing illumination conditions. In the graph here, you can see the green dots are the ground truth of where the rover is relative to the lander, and the red dots are the poses that are estimated by our neural network. And what you can see here is that the distance metric is quite accurate, whereas the orientation error is relatively large in comparison. And we can also see that the further we go away from the lander, the bigger the error. But overall, we can see that we get fairly consistent results regardless of where we are around our lander. And these are some initial plots where we also measure this more accurately. Then as a next step, we introduce our filtering, as I mentioned before, because essentially any false detections can introduce large localization errors into our system. So we would prefer to discard any possible false detections, even if this also removes correct detections. In order to do this, we use other available information. So we use the previously mentioned object detection to make sure the object is in the scene, but also to know where it is in the scene and to make sure that in that part of the image, the object is actually present. We also use the estimated pose to discard any estimated poses that are too large in distance, because we know after a certain distance, they become unreliable. And we also discard any cases where we have multiple detections. These are usually a sign of problematic detections. For our GraphSAM system, we use a standard GraphSAM setup where we have feature landmarks which are fed in with a covariance matrix. And for our setup, we use the exact same method to introduce our efficient post setup. And then we feed these in with our own confidence value as covariance matrix. We used RTAPMAP in this case. It already supports the use of custom landmarks, which is great. And it also has a database tool where you can essentially record your trajectory and procedurally change different links as covariance matrices in order to test procedurally which covariance matrix is the most useful as confidence value. Additionally, we also modified RTAPMAP to place the lander at the center of our world. This is especially interesting for our multi-robot use case, where we want to make sure that all the robots align their map in the with the lander in the center, and also that they always align it in the same way, regardless from which angle they approach the lander. The resulting trajectory you get out of this, here you can see the dotted line is the ground truth and the green line is the initial RTAPMAP estimate. And then we first feed this in with our landmarks with a unit matrix as covariance matrix. And we can already see improvements, but the real improvements come once we change the confidence level based on the distance. So the further we are away from the lander, the less confidence we have in our landmarks. To properly benchmark this setup, we produced a number of different trajectories of different length, but also different driving styles, and as well as different illumination conditions. So we actually, for some of these trajectories, changed the illumination conditions throughout the traverse, and we're still robust enough to properly relocalize with our landmarks. What we noticed in terms of results is that this system only really works well on longer traverses, because on very short traverses, the visual odometry on our system is just too good to really be improved on by this setup. But because this is a growing error, the relatively constant error of our setup can improve over the setup the longer we drive. As a result, we have a system that can continuously align the map to a known object without the need for any markers. And the map can also be aligned for multiple robots without the need for the robots to share any data. So regardless where the rover spawns, it will always align in the same way. The limitations we found is that the current pose estimation system that we used and trained still has a large rotational error, which leads to large position errors. But we are confident that because these are still fairly novel and with more training, that we could produce better pose estimation systems, which would actually improve this overall setup. That's it. Any questions?
Thank you very much, Philip. Is there any question in the audience? Okay, so let's thanks again, Philip. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your time.